Hello, baseball fans. Welcome back to Yankees Talk. And today, I apologize for any background noise or poor lighting. I will be back in my studio tomorrow. On Tuesday. But I saw some of you voted on my post, and I will be doing predictions and possible trades today. Let's start off with the trades. I have a prediction that the Yankees will go for a trade for Brian Reynolds now. The Yankees have been clearly stockpiling pitchers, whether it's in the minors or whether it's possibly just for the team in general. They signed two free agent pitchers as of recent to the minor leagues, as well as trading for Indigo Diaz from the Braves, which was one of the guys we got, other than Caleb Durbin. So, in my opinion, I think the Yankees are going all in, gathering as much pitching prospects as possible to acquire Brian Reynolds from the Pirates. The main reason I say that is because Brian Reynolds and the Pirates, or sorry, not Brian Reynolds, but the Pirates are looking for a lot of pitching prospects as they want to add pitching depth into their farm system or to their team in general for the bullpen or starting. And the Yankees don't have that as much. And by making these trades and acquiring some of these pitchers, it's getting this depth that is very much needed for the trade itself. And maybe looking a little more prone to the Pirates to, you know, give Brian Reynolds to the Yankees. So I think acquiring all this pitching is just a start to what the Yankees could do for the future. Next, I also have I saw a Ha-Seong Kim or Trent Grisham possibility that the Padres might give either of those two away. And I could very well see the Yankees going for Trent Grisham or any team that's in need of a center fielder or just any fielder in a spot, because Trent Grisham, although he didn't have a great season, in all honesty, Grisham had, in the past, has had really good career seasons. And I understand he didn't have as a great one last year and a below average, but he could bounce back and he could do really well in the upcoming seasons. He is a good all-around player. Ha-Seong Kim, too, second baseman or shortstop, very solid player. I actually, in one of my previous videos, have mentioned him and have stated that he could get traded from the Padres. So I could see this going very well for the Padres in return, because they are looking for pitching. And my actually hot take from a previous video was Ha-Seong Kim for Pablo Lopez of the Marlins. And the Padres are actually in heavy talks with the Marlins right now for that possibility of a trade. And I could see, honestly, Trent Grisham instead of Ha-Seong Kim at this point, because the Marlins are more in need of fielding than a second baseman. Now that they have Gene Segura, they also have Jazz Chisholm. There's no reason for them to go for Ha-Seong Kim, because now they can just swap Gene Segura and Jazz Chisholm and just run with that. And so I could see them going for Trent Grisham to add outfield depth and that needed field piece. I could also see the Orioles going for a pitcher of some kind in a trade. I could see them including a player such as Austin Hayes, or maybe possibly running back James McCann. And I understand James McCann just got moved there, but players can get moved multiple times in trades. We actually have seen that. Indigo Diaz got moved about 5 times between the Braves, the Yankees, and the Orioles, and a couple other teams. So James McCann being moved again wouldn't make, like, too little of sense. I could see him going to a team such as the Brewers, because I'm going to stick with my take from a recent video. I could see the Orioles possibly acquiring Corbin Burns, as a matter of fact. I only say that because the Brewers, I understand they want to stay competitive, and they were struggling a little bit last season, but Corbin Burns doesn't have much left on his contract, and so who knows if he's going to re-sign with the Brewers. So the Brewers might try and get all they can for him. And him going to the Orioles can give a lot for him. They can give them a catcher, which the Brewers now need a catcher after losing Omar Narváez and others. And James McCann could be that guy that they need and hoping for a bounce back season and or just for depth if they get somebody else. The Orioles, who are really in need of pitching, could really use Corbin Burns well, especially as that ace that they so desperately needed. And they could give up a couple other guys. I could see Austin Hayes, or not Anthony Santander, but Austin Hayes possibly going there as a piece, because although the Brewers don't really need Austin Hayes all that much, having him for depth and or just a starter when needed would be very good. And Austin Hayes would also just be a really solid trade piece in general as a player and player swap for just one guy being Corbin Burns would be a lot better than just a player for player. And I could see the Orioles also adding a couple prospects in there as well. Lastly, I'm going to go into predictions for a division. And today's division is going to be the AL.
Yeah, just a little intermission here. I understand I said the AL West in this video. I meant the AL Central. I was kind of trying to rush and get this video out really quick, and I just wasn't really thinking as much. So I meant AL Central, and AL West will be for another video. Thank you, and thank you all for your support. Back to the video.
The AL West. By saying the Detroit Tigers are finishing dead last. Yes, the Detroit Tigers have really tanked this offseason so far. They really haven't signed anybody. And they let go of Jamer Candelario. They let go of a couple key pieces. Sure, they have decent pitching. Sure, they have a decent bullpen. But in my opinion, they really don't have much else. They let go of the few guys they have. Miguel Cabrera, I mean, he's older. He's not really going to produce as much. They have Javi Baez, but Javier Baez can't be a one-man do-it-all team. I mean, there's only one guy who's really done that, which is Judge, but honestly, the rest of the team did help sometimes. Keyword sometimes. But in all honesty, Javi Baez isn't going to be that guy to carry a team on his back. And honestly, after last year sending Akil Badu down to the minors again and not really bringing him up too much, it just doesn't say much. I don't think the Tigers are going to be that good. And fourth, I'm going to put the Royals. The Royals aren't having a strong pitching staff again, and I could see them re-signing Zach Greinke, which would be a really strong signing and add to that pitching staff, but they don't have a great team overall after letting go of Whit Merrifield, Andrew Benintendi. I really don't see them competing all too much, and I really can't see them going as far. Obviously, they aren't going to be playoff contenders, division title contenders. There really isn't going to be much for them. So I don't really see them going for anywhere other than fourth. In third, I have the Minnesota Twins. And yes, I understand the Minnesota Twins looked really strong last season, but they ended up choking the division, having a really strong start of the season, but a really weak and very slow end of the season, hence why they ended up not winning the division. I could very well see the Twins being in third, as they still have important pieces. They have Jorge Polanco, who's very good. They have Byron Buxton, who's really good. They have Max Kepler, who's okay, but they might look to trade him. They have the Triple Crown winner, Luis Arraez. But I could see them finishing third only because of the fact that they also are losing out possibly on Gary Sanchez. I understand they re-signed Christian Vasquez, but honestly, that is about the same as Gary Sanchez. I mean, he has a little more offensive production and defensive, but not too much more. It's not too as significant. They traded away Gio Urshela, who played phenomenal for them this year, whether it was at third base or shortstop. And all around, it's just going to be a very more rebuilding year, rebuilding around the guys you have, rebuilding a team that you really just want for the future. And I could see the Twins doing well in 2024. I just can't see them doing as well in 2023 unless there are some breakout stars or breakout players that are going to happen. And second, I have the Chicago White Sox. The Chicago White Sox have not gotten as good as we all thought they have. Sure, they have re-signed Andrew Benintendi, or not re-signed, but signed Andrew Benintendi, but they also lost Jose Abreu to the Astros. They haven't really filled that first base void yet, and they have just about the same team as last year. They have a really good pitching staff. They have great players like Benintendi now. They have Mercedes. They have Tim Anderson. But honestly, it's just a few guys, and they really underperformed last season, or they overperformed the year before. Either way, I don't see them surpassing the number one team, obviously, the Cleveland Guardians, and they just aren't as good yet as them. And it's going to be hard competing with them because the Guardians have gotten better compared to the White Sox, who have gotten a little bit worse, in my opinion. And they really just have a generally same team as last year, which isn't going to get you far. So I don't really see them making it anywhere past second, but I could see them possibly picking up a wild card spot. And it'd be a really tight race between teams such as the Mariners and whoever gets second and third in that division, the Angels, the Rays, the Blue Jays, the Yankees, whoever comes in first, second, third in that division. But in first in the AL West, I have the Cleveland Guardians. Sorry, the AL Central. I have the Cleveland Guardians. The Guardians have gotten better this season, this offseason. They signed Josh Bell to a 2-year deal, who is a really good all-around player, switch hitter, great first baseman. I love that signing. They have one of the top rookies from last year, Stephen Kwan. Very, very low strikeout rate. All-around great contact guy. Not a ton of power, but you want contact. They have a phenomenal defensive and offensive third baseman in Jose Ramirez. They have Josh Naylor, who, as a Yankees fan, yeah, I hated that, but we got revenge on him. But they have Josh Naylor, who, don't get me wrong, he is a really good player, no matter how much I hate him. Yeah, I can't take that away from him. And they really have a solid all-around team. And the Guardians, who have really picked it up in the second half of last season, I could see just continuing with that momentum through 2023. They had a great wild card series, had a really competitive ALDS. And this momentum, I could really see them carrying to another division win in 2023. So, therefore, I would have the Cleveland Guardians winning the AL Central and taking it back and going to the postseason yet again. But that is all for the video today, guys. Please let me know your predictions in the comments, your reactions, thoughts, any feedback you may have. I thank you all for watching and the support as of recent. I just got boosted up to 60 subscribers, so thank you all. And I will see you all in the next video. Thank you.